conference room on BCTV is supported by RDO Consulting Group, LLC.
And welcome to another program of the conference room. This is a series of 14 programs. This one today is number 5. We're recording it at the studios of BCTV on the beautiful campus of Albright College. These programs run on the second Wednesday and the fourth Tuesday at 9 p.m. every week, and we encourage you to tune in. We also want to thank the Volander Group for providing their support. And the BCTV staff here, Heather, who runs things, Joan and John in engineering, and Rose behind the camera. And BCTV certainly deserves the entire community's support. You can log on to bctv.org and see their massive selection of programming. The underwriter, RDO Consulting, LLC, and I'm Bob Orzechowski, and I'm sharing the program with you today for HR, or Human Resources, in the COVID-19 era, World War C. The disclaimer, of course, we've already seen. It's a busy program. We have 30 minutes, actually 29 minutes now, and we're going to plow through this rather quickly. We wanted to share some learning objectives here, emphasize the serious nature of COVID-19. You may know people that still think it's a wild conspiracy and it's not real. We want to give you some ideas about how to handle things at work and things at home. We are at war. We need a wartime mentality. HR, Human Resources, has to perform as a strategic business partner more now than ever before. This is a picture of myself as a combat Marine in Vietnam, and you can see we're all geared up with our makeup and our personal protective equipment and flak vests and all that. And this is a group of warriors now on the front lines. They too are geared up, and they have their uniforms and whatever they need to protect themselves. Folks, we're in a war, and I can't emphasize that enough. To keep that selection going with the wartime, Murphy's Rules of Combat, there are several of them, but the number one rule is you are not Superman. And we emphasize that because I still am amazed at seeing people not practice social distancing, not wearing masks, not taking care of themselves, and just generally being careless. A little bit about the virus first with our first learning objective, how serious this is. Novel virus means just that. It's a no real name for this yet. It's endemic to humans, but it's new, unusual, unique, and unexpected. It's still changing, and seems like, I know it seems like forever, 6 months maybe, that it's been around, and we're still learning every day. The problem is we're drinking from a fire hose, and we're getting information from multiple sources, sometimes conflicting information, which is a real challenge. So we don't really know where to go as families, as employers, as employees. And I know our own travel policy, we've designed probably 4 times in the last month and a half. Understand there's no vaccine. There are drugs out there treating symptoms depending on your age and how efficacious they are. There's lots of trials going on, but very few double-blinded randomized trials. Obviously there's a cost to developing these vaccines, and hopefully we'll have one sooner than later. Personal protective equipment. If you've ever tried to buy masks, and here we have some really basic ones. If you've ever tried to buy masks, some of them are terribly expensive if you can find them at all. Some will not be sourced from the United States, which is a big problem. You should know that. The personal protective equipment is not just for healthcare workers like you saw in the previous photo. The supply chain is volatile. We have shifted some manufacturing from other items to more gowns, gloves, masks. There was a time when we thought we had to wipe everything down before we touched it. Some things we know, the life of the virus on hard surfaces maybe isn't what it used to be, but again, nobody wanted to take a risk. So approved masks, gloves, face shields sometimes, and disinfectant wipes are scarce, but you can make your own wipes with white cotton napkins, cloth napkins, and a mild bleach solution that, again, though, the bleach solution only lasts a few hours or maybe a day at the most. Testing's out there. Accuracy is the big problem. From the employment world, the EEOC may not even allow such things, such kind of testing to go on because of the ADA rules. And there's numerous kinds of tests. These slides will all be available to you when you watch the program, again, second Wednesday and fourth Tuesdays of the month. Our series of programs will run. And you can also access them on the Valander Group website, and that will be at the bottom of the program. There's a slide on that as well. Contact tracing is another issue that's coming big now. We want to find out if you did test positive, who you were with, how long you were with them, where they are. And there's software out there to try to find these people. But I have to tell you that it's severely underprotected from cyber attacks. And if you remember some of our previous programs, Cybersecurity 101, encryption, passwords, penetration testing, all those programs are available on our website. And I can tell you, though, that contact tracing software, while it might be of some value, is very open to cyber attacks. So please be careful with that. Safety procedures for employers. Understand that there's a general duty clause from the Occupational Safety and Health Administration that requires employers to provide a safe workplace. And so they've redesigned, I know here at the studio at BCTV, they've redesigned the workspace here as well as the studio itself. But certainly developing response plans, no non-essential visitors, display posters that are required, check daily with the Pennsylvania Department of Health for guidance on red states and whatever, and the confidentiality mandate, of course. Okay, the human side of human resource management and what I call World War C for COVID. I think HR is going to be key to providing a supportive workplace, not just a safe workplace, but we're talking about a supportive workplace. Imagine people that have school-age children and they're worried about that. People that have been furloughed, had their hours reduced, actually had been laid off. And if they don't have the economic resources and the tremendous pressure they're on. Keeping with the wartime scenario, the rules of engagement. There were times when we couldn't even have a magazine in the weapon, and other times when you could have the magazine locked and loaded and the safety off. So rules of engagement here in the workplace, even in the normal commercial world, how you say it matters. Honesty tempered with respect. It's not what you say sometimes, it's how you say it that matters. And keep in mind the recipient's perception of how you're communicating, and harmony always above anger or insult, and we'll get through this. Employees, the Employee Assistance Program. This is a kind of service that employers can contract with local providers. You can Google EAP programs in Berks County, in Pennsylvania. Some of them are nationwide. And a lot of employers already contract with these Employee Assistance Program outfits, and they have counselors, they have therapists, they can make referrals that normally group health insurance might cover. Some of it can have no charge. So I would buddy to employers, if they have an EP, best friend. We want to think of HR as that strategic business partner, and some of the roles and challenges and opportunities. Now more than ever, human resources personnel trust build business. It's the new workplace currency in World War III. No time anymore for being obtuse or about things. Straight answers might not like, but they need straight answers. Effective HR competencies are going to optimize this opportunity for victory in this war. You got to stay informed. Know the business operations and the weak points in the process, bottlenecks, breakdowns. The HR program implementation, policy development, get multiple inputs before you come up with a rule. We have to enable more technology than ever, and certainly being aware culturally, because this virus is hitting different segments of the population differently. A note about safety. A well-managed company is a safe and profitable company. You can't ever eliminate risk. You can choose which risks you'll try to minimize. Obviously, we don't have to worry much about a zombie apocalypse, but we do have to worry about being sued for negligence, for instance. You want to certainly maintain productivity, maybe have a safety committee, or especially now have a COVID committee. And you can also check with the Occupational Safety and Health Administration on some kind of guidance for preparing workplaces for COVID-19 if you haven't already done that. Keeping with the strategic partner focus with human resource management, and if you're a small business out there and you really don't have a full-time HR pro, there are several consulting companies out there that can help you with that. Your attorney may be able to help you with that. And you can certainly contact me at the website and mobile number that appeared at the top of the program and may also appear at the bottom of the program. And we can certainly steer you to somebody. Where you want to begin, obviously you have to plug into the agencies that are out there, the Centers for Disease Control, the Food and Drug Administration, the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, the Environmental Protection Agency, Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, the Pennsylvania Department of Health, Department of Labor, the County of Berks. Berks County also has a chapter of the Society for Human Resource Management. You can reach them as well, or reach out to me and I can put you in. You've got to stay informed now. Sometimes it's going to seem it conflicts and some will sink. Obviously, you've got to keep current with guidelines for health safety, cleaning, disinfection. And there's a difference between cleaning and disinfecting, too, by the way, folks. Testing is constantly changing because we're learning more with each round of these tests. And there are only industry-specific protocols and standards, depending on if it's healthcare, schools, mining companies, banking. They're all going to have slightly different rules, but they're all going to have some things in common, which I'm sure you've seen already. No entry without a mask, for instance. Keep employees informed. Hygiene, meetings and travel, review your travel policy, certainly distancing, stay home if you're ill. If you've traveled, especially this summer, you've traveled to a red state, just be sure that there's some quarantining going on. Where can you really begin to put human resources and employees together as strategic business partners here? Have some protocols. There's got to be aligned with business operations. We've seen employment tick up a little bit in certain industries. We see it still lagging behind in others. Some employers maybe aren't going to have the rehiring everybody as fast as we'd like. Remote working certainly is a big thing now. And there you have, of course, productivity and confidentiality issues. Health screening protocols. And again, you have to keep in mind the American with Disabilities Act there and making some reasonable accommodations through the ability to work from home if that's possible. Well-written job descriptions, very, very important. If you don't have well-written job descriptions, and they may have changed now with new processes in the workplace, that's a good place to start. And cleaning and disinfecting procedures, there's going to be a productivity hit just because between visits, between customers, got to kind of delay. We can't, but done here at this, we're leverage tech. And, cybersecurity, if you have any about the cybersecurity, get onto some reasonable accommodations through the ability to work from home if that's possible. Well-written job descriptions, very, very important. If you don't have well-written job descriptions, and they may have changed now with new processes in the workplace, that's a good place to start. And cleaning and disinfecting procedures, there's going to be a productivity hit just because between visits, between customers, got to kind of delay. We can't, but done here at the delay. We can't, but done here at the wherever leverage tech and cybersecurity. If you have any about the cyber, take it onto the done here at the wherever leverage tech. Cybersecurity. If you have any about the cyber, take it on to the leverage tech. Cybersecurity. If you have any about the cyber, take it on to the cybersecurity. If you have any about the cyber, take it on to the group website. You can take it on to the group website. You can add aspects of cybersecurity. Very serious right about now, folks. Policies. You will be able to identify policies and travel policies that we've revised ours several times. And that's because State Department of Health or the CD entered several times. Paid time. Do you have a leave necessary? I know couple because the employees don't have any care of their schedule. That just exacerbates this model. Recruiting, training, we want to have this now. You want to be able to engage your employees of benefits that employees are offered. As far as leaves of absence, Family Medical Leave Act now has been extended in certain industries to employers with fewer than 50 people, and that's where the required posters, promulgates poster, they provide it to you, download them as PDFs, laminated, some easier to read, interacting with I know couple because the employees don't have any care of their schedule. That just exacerbates this model. Recruiting, training, we want to have this now. You want to be able to engage your employees of benefits that employees are offered. As far as leaves of absence, Family Medical Leave Act now has been extended in certain industries to employers with fewer than 50 people. And that's where the required posters, promulgates poster, they provide it to you, download them as PDFs, laminated, some easier to read. Interacting with be sure the workers' compensation date, the have the short individual or long-term disability policy, it be synced with anything else employer has. Accommodation is certainly have American with Disabilities, the Rehab Act, Rehabilitation Act of Employment Opportunity Commission, state laws, essentialities about information will be covered by HIPAA. You have to know all the and privacy rules. The five C's of leadership. Every war requires good leadership and strategy. Good tactics won't compensate for a bad strategy. And so we have to bring in the concept when we talk about war, we talk about military, of course, or even militia and civilian units, leadership from people. And that includes people at the highest levels of the land, in the state, in the federal government, in the agencies that we rely on to give us the information we need to make good decisions. It relies on community leaders. It relies on leaders in the family and in the home. But HR and in the working environment is uniquely situated to be that strategic business partner when it comes to leadership. Culture, certainly. Walk the first task of leadership. It's not what you say, it's how you say it. Honesty, openness, harmony above anger. We have to be able to recognize the power of transparent interaction and embrace it. Create trust. Remember, it's the new currency in the workplace. Connectivity. We have remote working. We have Zoom meetings, Skype meetings. All these related technologies are tools. And to use it to create accountability, not just to track somebody if they've logged onto their computer or not. Collaboration, key to unleashing the organization's strategic advantage. You have a lot of people in your organization, or if you're an organization, sure, it has a mission. You are stronger when you're united. And of course, confidence. COVID's going to test our mettle, just like any battlefield does, just like any enemy does. It's going to test your mettle. And your organizations as well. You have to focus on your strengths, recognize your weaknesses and shore them up, and I think we'll get through this. I wanted to say a little bit about the Volander Group. It's an organization, it's veteran owned, It was started by Eric Roebuck some time ago, and there are five individuals associated with it right now. Dale Rothenberger handles a lot of marketing and training, and John, he's the accountant and our vice president of finances and financial controls. And we certainly have Chuck Holder with a broad and deep experience in the busy local at businesses, connected man I know, and management. Broad and deep, over 40 years of experiment. And, there's a need out there, and I can't emphasize enough, the phishing attack. I know I saw life when we advertise for equipment. Careful to, these are a lot of scams out there. You'll send in money for products that are just too good to be true in terms of price or quality or free shipping kind of things, and you never get the product and you gave them a credit card number. Sometimes it's better to use PayPal, which is linked to your credit card, but the credit card number doesn't show. You might want to consider things like that if you're on your own, and to be careful of this in a company is very likely. Phishing, certainly, P-H-I-S-H-I-G, not the phishing you might do out at Blue Marsh. The bad guys can get in there through carelessness, so human factor engineering is critical. I think we want to be sure that your employees are trained, the infrastructure kind. You need IT consultants for penetration testing, vulnerability testing. It may not be a wise decision to use your own staff to conduct the vulnerability analysis on the infrastructure they developed. Sometimes it's always best to have a second opinion, especially in something like that. And that's not to cast aspersion onto the competency or quality of any IT infrastructure or vendor. It's just that sometimes they can get too close to the issues. So penetration testing, and depending on what industry you're in, is actually required. You have to have a security risk analysis performed, and your current IT staff can certainly do that, but it's the penetration and vulnerability testing that ought to be outsourced to a different organization. We also have training on passwords, and be surprised the number of people that use password as a password, same for multiple applications. And these are the Volander Group can help you with. One or more of the five individuals and your staff, we've got deep grounds in all of them. We have the land. This is the fifth bag, and we're getting down to the programs coming, risk management, about the four or five P's of marketing. Now we have finance. We have terms on cost control, business procedures. We have our coming on, and as our security. If you have questions or comments, you can certainly send them to group our phone number. The website. For products that are just too good to be true in terms of price or quality or free shipping kind of things, and you never get the product and you gave them a credit card number. Sometimes it's better to use PayPal, which is linked to your credit card, but the credit card number doesn't show. You might want to consider things like that if you're on your own. And to be careful of this in a company is very likely. Phishing, certainly, P-H-I-S-H-I-G, not the phishing you might do out at Blue Marsh. Bad guys can get in there through carelessness. So human factor engineering is critical. I think we want to be sure that your employees are trained, the infrastructure kind. IT consultants for penetration testing, vulnerability testing. It may not be a wise decision to use your own staff to conduct the vulnerability analysis on the infrastructure they developed. Sometimes it's always best to have a second opinion, especially in something like that. And that's not to cast aspersion onto the competency or quality of any IT infrastructure or vendor. It's just that sometimes they can get too close to the issues. So Penetration testing, and depending on what industry you're in, is actually required. You have to have a security risk analysis performed, and your current IT staff can certainly do that, but it's the penetration and vulnerability testing that ought to be outsourced to a different organization. We also have training on passwords, and be surprised the number of people that use password as a password, same for multiple applications. And these are the Volander Group can help you with. One or more of the individuals and your staff, we've got deep grounds in all of them. We have the land. This is the fifth bag, and we're getting down to the programs coming risk management, about the four or five P's of marketing. Now we have finance. We have terms on cost control, business procedures. We have our coming on, and as over security. If you have questions or comments, you can certainly send them to group. Our phone number, the website, www.valancy.com, the folks that are in the group. And we certainly want to thank Bob Orzechowski for the underwriting of to be sort of like and time in front of people talking to us and whatever. That's why we've settled on third program in QX and so BC Station. And I want to thank Heather, Joan, John, and Rose behind the camera there for bringing you these programs. Now BC programs, now we're international YouTube, and they're a tremendous community source. Wide range of individuals working, they have about the four or five pieces of marketing. Now we have finance, we have terms on cost control, business procedures, we have our coming on, and as over security. If you have questions or comments, you can certainly send them to group. Our phone number, the website. We have our coming on, and as over security. If you have questions or comments, you can certainly send them to group. Our phone number, the website, www.valancy.com. The folks that are in the group, and we certainly want to thank Bob Orzechowski for the underwriting of to be sort of like and time in front of people talking to us and whatever. That's why we've settled on third program in QX and so BC Station. And I want to thank Heather, Joan, John, and Rose behind the camera there for bringing you these programs. Now BC programs, now we're international YouTube, and they're a tremendous community source. Wide range of individuals working to have programs activity in the studio. We want to thank Bob Orzechowski for 40 years managerial in both high tech and healthcare, but another in universities and business programs, big courses, community, local Berks, Pennsylvania region, been heavily involved in the Society for Human Management as well. So, anyway.